Hi, I'm Susan Arndt, and this is the video supplement for our review of Limbo. On paper, Limbo sounds like a fairly ordinary puzzle platformer. You move from left to right, overcoming environmental obstacles in order to make progress. You've got all of three controls available to you. You can move, you can jump, and you can interact with the environment, which usually involves stuff like flipping a switch, pushing a box, or climbing a rope. You've probably played a couple of dozen games that could be described the exact same way, but none of them are quite like Limbo. For starters, they're probably not quite as intent on killing you. Make no mistake, you are going to die a lot as you try to solve Limbo's ingenious puzzles, and in all sorts of different ways. You can fall down a hole, drown, have something drop on your head, get ground up in gears, get squished by a trap, fall on spikes, get speared by a spider, be electrocuted, or my personal favorite, step on a bear trap. Or two. Maybe three. Rampant and frequently unsettling depictions of death aside, Limbo is a staggeringly beautiful game. It's simple, stark, and lovely, creating amazing depth and mood with the most basic of graphics and color schemes. In an industry constantly throwing every graphic trick it can think of at you, Limbo elegantly proves that less can be a lot, lot more. In fact, you'll probably get so caught up looking at the beautiful imagery that you'll die once or twice. Once you accept the fact that you're going to be croaking every few seconds, you begin to appreciate how clever Limbo's puzzles are. Everything you'll need to solve them is right in front of you, and while sometimes getting through them relies on timing, for the most part it's all about putting your brain to work, figuring out how to use your few abilities with the objects at hand to get past the obstacle and move on. You'll figure out pretty quickly that in addition to being an extremely smart game, Limbo has a very, very dark sense of humor. The first few times you die, it's kind of annoying, but after a while it becomes so frequent that you just have to laugh at your tiny little corpse flopping around or being torn to pieces. And just what is the proper etiquette for using a corpse to solve a puzzle? I mean, I think I'm okay with using one to trigger a trap, but is it rude to walk across a freshly drowned body to get across the water? I'm a bit fuzzy on the propriety here.